Hi there. Today, to make the most of our math block, we're going to take a look at what I keep inside my math cart. Now, this math cart is prepped and ready to go with different ideas for your number talks or your math routines to get your math block started. I have the activity cards prepped and ready to go, and then I have the hands-on materials that I'll use to go along with them. I also keep my number talk book so I can have the verbiage that I want to follow along with during those number talk activities. So let's take a closer look and see what's inside. I've emptied the cart so we can fill it together to see what we use to organize and what's inside. The first thing I have is this divider so I can organize all the cards. And I have this clear pencil box that I keep the hands-on tools in. The first activity is eliminate it. And we usually say, one of these things is not like the other, eliminate it. And they raise their hand and tell me which one they would eliminate. For this one, most of them would say three because the rest are two. So these are eliminated. The next activity I have are the quick image 10 frame cards. So I'm going to quickly show them how many, and they can either show me on their fingers how many they see, or they can build it on the tens frame. I have these foam ones that they can pull apart. So I keep that in my material bin and my tens frame cards in here. The next activity are these scattered cubes. On the different cards, it's the same idea. I'm going to quickly show them how many, and they can show me with their fingers how many they see, or they can use their own connecting cubes to build it in front of them. The next activity is our five frame. So same idea, I'm going to quickly show them. They can show me with their fingers, or they can build it on our foam five frame. I have these skill strips that we use all the time. You're going to quickly show them. You can use the document camera or just hold it up so they can do it. And they'll write how many they see on their dry erase board. So they would write 9, 8 and continue on for their different representations. Another one is our domino quick image. So you're going to show them quickly how many. And for this one, I love to do the hands-on tools with it. So they'll build it how many they see and try to build it in the same arrangement. So they'll have their three going down and they might say, I saw three going diagonal, or I saw three, one, two, three. And if you need, I keep a bigger model card for students that need help organizing it. This one I usually tuck in the back since it's big, and this one in the front, and keep these in. The next activity is tile arrangement, same thing as domino arrangement, except they're using their tiles to remember how many they saw and try to remember how they saw it. So they might say, I know that there were four across and one more below. So they're using their tiles to build that. Another one is REKENREK quick image. So you're going to show them. For this one, at first they might need more modeling and they might need you to just hold it up the whole time. And they can show it with their fingers, or they can use their hands-on tool to show you how many they saw. I also keep my number talk book. You can just keep a little post-it note or anything to keep track of what page you're in and to just kind of build that number sense. So I just slide it over, close my bin, and tuck it in. You may have to just kind of move around what you need. So we have our tiles, our double-sided counters, our hands-on math tools, our domino arrangement, tile arrangement, REKENREK quick image, skill strips, five frame cards, scattered arrangement cards, tens frame quick image, eliminate it, our larger model mat for our domino quick image. And I also sometimes keep our larger tens frames so they can use that for their 10 frame quick image if you don't have those foam tens frames.
I hope you're able to set up your own math cart or your own math space in your classroom so you can have those number talks and build in those math routines with your students. If this video was helpful to you, make sure you like it and remember to stay tuned for more videos of making the most of our math block.